Hello and welcome to Shrey Academy online teaching classes. Today again I am going to continue lesson 4, A Little World of Murder. In the previous video I have already given you the word meanings of difficult word and the explanation of the lesson 2. Today I am going to continue the exercise of this lesson. So let's start the exercise. Our first exercise is read the sentence and answer the questions. It means that some lines of this lessons are given to you and on the basis of this some questions are asked to you. So the first one is, everyone went back to bed but I was obliged to stay awake. The questions are, why had everyone woken up some time ago? The second is, how was everyone able to go to bed again? Third is, why was the narrator obliged to stay awake? And the last is, what did the narrator do before breakfast in the morning? So answer of the first question is, why had everyone woken up sometimes ago? The answer is, the entire household was awakened by a loud and fearful noise. Once again I speak, the entire household was awakened by a loud and fearful noise. The next question is, how was everyone able to go to bed again? The answer is, when grandfather gave the bottle a good shaking, the frog stayed quiet. Once again I speak, when grandfather gave the bottle a good shaking, the frog stayed quiet. The next question is, why was the narrator obliged to stay awake? The answer is, the narrator obliged to stay awake to shake the bottle whenever the frog showed sign of bursting into song. Once again I speak, the narrator obliged to stay awake to shake the bottle whenever the frog showed sign of bursting into song. The next question is, what did the narrator do before the breakfast in the morning? The answer is, the narrator wanted to release the frogs into the garden before the breakfast. Once again I speak, the narrator want to release the frogs into the garden before the breakfast. Now the second line is, we must acknowledge their right on the earth. And the question based on these lines are, who said these words and to whom? Whose rights are being talked about? And how are their rights being threatened? And what does this tell us about the speaker? So the answer of the first question is, who said this word and to whom? The answer is, the grandfather said this word to the speaker. Once again I speak, the grandfather said this word to the speaker. Next question is, whose rights are being talked about? The answer is, the rights are being talked about the birds and animals. Once again I speak, the rights are being talked about the birds and animals. The next question is, how are their rights being threatened? The answer is, their rights are being threatened by destroying their forests, due to which they find difficult to live, and by killing them indiscriminately. Once again I speak, their rights are being threatened by the destroying their forest, due to which they find difficult to live, and by killing them indiscriminately. And the next question is, what does this tell us about the speaker? And the answer is, this tell us that speaker is very kind and gentle towards animals. Once again I speak, this tell us that the speaker is very kind and gentle towards animals. Now the next exercise is, answer these questions. And the first question is, why didn't all the frogs came to the surface of the pond at once? The answer is, the frog didn't came to the surface at once because they don't know whether the grandfather and speaker are friends or enemy, as they are afraid of Heron's bird, who might have been wading about in search of frogs. Once again I speak, the frog didn't came to the surface at once because they don't know whether the grandfather and the speaker are friends or enemy, as they are afraid of Heron's bird, who might have been wading about in search of frogs. The next question is, why did the narrator's grandfather say that tadpoles eating each other was a useful system? The answer is, the narrator's grandfather said because if thousands of young tadpoles in the pond become frogs, then there will be no sufficient place for them in the pond. Then they will occupy every inch of the ground between the pond and her house. Once again I speak, the narrator's grandfather said because if thousands of young tadpoles in the pond become frogs, then there will be no sufficient place for them in the pond. Then they will occupy every inch of the ground between the pond and her house. Now the next question is, what happened when the boys on the buffalo's back saw the narrator looking at him? Answer is, when the boy on the buffalo's back saw the narrator looking at him, he smiled at the narrator and invited him into the water for a swim. Once again I speak, when the boy on the buffalo's back saw the narrator looking at him, he smiled at the narrator and invited him into the water for a swim. And the next question is, according to Ramu, how did squirrels get dark lines on their backs? Answer is, according to Ramu, the dark lines are the marks of Lord Krishna's fingers. He loved squirrels. He would took them in his hand and stroke them with his long fingers. That is why they have four dark lines down their back from head to tail. Once again I speak, according to Ramu, the dark lines are the marks of Lord Krishna's finger. He loved squirrels. He would took them in his hands and stroke them with his long fingers. That is why they have four dark lines down their back from the head to tail. Our next exercise is fill in the blanks with the correct word. As you can see, some words are given in the box and you have to choose the correct words in the following fill in the blanks. So the first one is, one of the most attractive features of India is its rich cultural depth. The answer is diversity. One of the most attractive features of India is its rich cultural diversity. Now the next one is, the poachers knew they were in dire danger when the tigers surrounded them. The answer is mortal. The poachers knew they were in mortal danger when the tigers surrounded them. The next one is, traffic was so bad that Suvrat was dashed to get off the bus and walk to school. Answer is obliged. The traffic was so bad that Suvrat was obliged to get off the bus and walk to school. Now the next is, Samya saw a little boy dash the lake and jumped into to save him. The answer is floundering. Ramya saw a little boy floundering into the lake and jumped in to save him. Now the next one is, Naseem uncle is dash in Sanskrit grammar. The answer is well versed. Naseem uncle is well versed in Sanskrit grammar. Now the next one is, Abhay's sister is his best friend and also his confidant. The answer is confident. The Abhay's sister is his best friend and also his confidant. Student, there are two questions in exercise 3. Think and answer. The first question is, what difference do you notice in the natures of narrator's grandfather and grandmother? And the second question is, the narrator's grandmother held strict views about his mixing with village children. Do you agree with the grandmother? Give reason for your answer. So these two questions are homework to you. You have to think and answer the question. It means that you have to think, and in your words you have to give the answer that what is the different nature the grandfather and the grandmother have. And in the second question you have to find out whether it is true that by mixing to the village children as is good for us or not. So you have to present your views on this answer. Okay student, thank you for today's class. Now, this is your homework. You have to write and learn all the exercise of this lesson in your copy with neat and clean writing. And after writing it, you have to learn it also because it is also very important.